Several readers have requested information about using the manual modes on the Coolpix P610. We're going to go through a series of shots and step through some of the manual features.
For this shot, we're going to use all manual mode. We're going to set our ISO at 100. Going to set our f-stop at 3.3 using our rotary selector. And then what we need to do is set our shutter speed so that our exposure indicator is in the middle. And we need to keep going to a lower shutter speed until we're in the middle. So we are set for a proper exposure now, 1/40th of a second at 3.3. Focus and shoot. And if we review that and take a look at this, it's fairly properly exposed. We have a white sheet over in this area that is fairly close to the light, so that's a little overexposed, but it's not detracting from the subject at all.
If we take a look at our photograph, it's properly exposed. Zooming in on the front subject, we see good detail. If we take a look at the background, it's out of focus, which gives a pleasingly soft photograph.
For this shot, we want to keep the same ISO as we had before, which is ISO 100. And we want to see what happens as we change the f-stop and balance it with the shutter speed. So let's run our f-stop up 1, 2, 3 clicks to 4.8. And notice on our exposure meter now, it shows 3 clicks underexposed. So that means that we have to adjust that with our command dial, reducing our shutter speed to 1/20th to balance it out. So one click on the aperture control or the f-stop control equals one click on our shutter speed. If we shoot that picture again,
again, we have a properly exposed photo.
For this shot, we want to see the relationship between the ISO setting and the shutter speed and f-stop. So let's go to our menu, and we're going to bump the ISO up to 200. And notice now that 200 changed the exposure 3 clicks overexposed. That means that we have to do either 3 clicks on the aperture or 3 clicks on the shutter speed. Let's change our shutter speed. 1, 2, 3. 3 clicks on the shutter speed gives us back to 1/40th of a second, and it neutralizes our exposure gauge. So if we shoot that shot,
by changing the shutter speed and lens opening, we can compensate for changes in the ISO setting. For the next shot, we've changed the distances from the lens to the subjects. We've increased the distance of the first model about twice as much. The back model is about the same distance as it was from the first model. And we've zoomed in a little more so that the image size is about the same.
On this shot, we want to change the f-stop so it's wide open. And since we've zoomed in a little bit on this shot, it won't go all the way to 3.3. So we can get it down to 4.5. And we need to have the shutter speed compensate for that, or three clicks above the neutral point. So what we want to do is stop down or change that shutter speed so it's neutral now, and we want to shoot that photo.
Notice on this photograph that when we zoomed in on the first model and kept the distance between the first model and the second model the same, it seems to bring the second model a little closer to the first model.
For this shot, we've moved the secondary model back to about 24 inches behind the front model. And what we want to do is open the shutter as far as we can, which is 4.2, since we're zoomed in a little bit. And then we have to change the shutter speed to compensate for that. And that gets it to 1/50th of a second. And let's shoot.
On this shot, we still have it properly exposed, but notice that when we zoom in on the front subject, that we still have good detail as we had before. But when we zoom in on the back subject that has been moved back considerably, it is far more out of focus than on the previous shot.
On this shot, we want to see what happens when we make a little more aggressive press on the shutter release. We're going to set the ISO at 100. We're going to set the f-stop to max, which is 7.6 at this range. And then we'll adjust the shutter speed to compensate. Probably won't have to be too aggressive at 1/8 of a second. But what we want to do is compare what happens with a slow shutter speed with a faster shutter speed. So let's shoot this one.
You can see the camera move a little bit when I press the shutter release aggressively. And when we zoom in on the image, you can see that it's blurry compared to the one that we shot previously.
For this shot, we want to see how an aggressive shutter release press is affected when we set the shutter speed quite high. So we're going to change our settings. We're going to change the f-stop so it's as wide open as we can get it at this zoom range. We're going to go to our menu and change the ISO sensitivity to 1600. That will give us a pretty high shutter speed capability. And then we'll change our shutter speed so that it will compensate for the other changes that we've had there. So we're up to 1/400th of a second. And let's focus and shoot.
Again, you could see the camera move a little bit when I pressed the shutter release aggressively. When we zoom in on this one, the detail is still clear because we had a higher shutter speed. One of the questions I have often been asked is, how is the bokeh of the P610? Bokeh is the blurring of the background because lenses focus on a particular point, and things in front of and behind that point are out of focus to a certain extent. This is also referred to as depth of field. Aperture is frequently used to control the depth of field. Small aperture increases the depth of field, and a large aperture decreases it. The P610 lacks the range of f-stops needed to control depth of field very much, but it is still flexible enough to produce blurred backgrounds. You just have to use a little different technique. Let's look at a depth of field calculator from CambridgeInColor.com. and see what can be done to throw background out of focus. You can see here that we have the digital compact sensor with 1 over 2.3. That's the same sensor that we have in the P610. I've selected an aperture of f4. That's because we can't get to the biggest aperture that we have on the 610, which is 3.3, but 4 comes close enough. We're going to start with our focal length set to 4.3, which is the widest angle that we can set. And we'll start with our 3 foot distance to the subject and calculate. So we're 3 feet away from our subject, but the things that are going to be in acceptable focus go out to infinity. So we're not going to get much blurring in the background with things set like that. Let's move our camera back from the subject a little bit. We're going to go to 10 feet. We're going to change the focal length so that we get the same vertical distance. And with a 3 foot distance, we had about a 3 foot height in our viewfinder with it in the landscape mode. So we're going to set the focal length that is necessary to get the same height. And that focal length would be about 14 millimeters. We calculate that. We started at 10 feet from our subject, and notice that our acceptable focus is going to be at 15 feet, which is now just a little over 5 feet behind our subject. Rather than going out to infinity, things that are beyond 15 feet are going to be slightly out of focus, and the further that you move from 15 feet back, the further out of focus it's going to be. Let's take one more step. We'll go to a focal length of 60 to get the same 3 foot height of our subject. We have to change the subject distance to 43 feet. Maybe some of you will be comfortable with a 43 foot distance to your subject. A lot of people get uncomfortable when it gets too close. Let's calculate that. Now we're starting at 43 feet from the subject. And our furthest point of acceptable focus is only 46 feet. So that's only 3 feet behind our subject. Anything further back gets more out of focus. So we can get that softened background by moving back away from our subject and changing the focal length, just zooming in on the subject. And that's how we get better bokeh. This is a shot of a Christmas tree with lights, slow shutter speed, and move the camera a little bit. This shot is one of my cooperative figurines using a slow shutter speed. The camera is sliding directly toward the figurine and using a rear curtain on a flash, which flashes at the end of the shutter time rather than at the beginning. This is a combination of slow shutter speed and rotating the camera on a tripod during the exposure and rear curtain with a flash. This is a combination of a slow shutter speed with a neutral density filter, which allows for that slow shutter speed on a bright day. I hope you enjoyed the video and it will inspire you to try out some of the manual settings. Thank you for viewing, and if you enjoyed this, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks.